Very on theme.
Every turn in this game, we kill dudes, we get clues. That is how I plan to move on. Far across the boat deck, the lifeboat is waiting. We just need some clues to get on. Move fast. This map is quite vast, and I know that the boss guy is strong. Fate, let's open this crate, 'cause we're here on this ship, and this ship will not last too long.
Spoiler alert.
I will fight the Titan, the water he heightens, but I hope it will go back down. You go find the tablet, the cultists, they have it. If they keep it, we will all drown. Move fast, this map is quite vast, and I know that the boss guy is strong. Fate, let's open this crate, 'cause we're here on this ship, and this ship will not last too long.
One more chorus, baby. Key change.
He's near. It's what we all fear. And I can't take the hit on Milan. We'll stay in this watery grave. Ended our game, but our campaign will still go on.
Oh shit, it was coming.
Welcome, viewers, to another special edition of TNA Thursday Night Arkham tonight. It's me, Scott, over there, that's Sean, and we're on a boat. We're supposed to be socially distancing, but screw that, we're going on a cruise. Take it away, Sean.
Thanks, Scott. Hi, everyone. Welcome to this very special Thursday Night Arkham. With me is, of course, as you can... Sorry, I blew past it, but I have to take a moment to appreciate exactly what that was.
Brought tear to your eye, hey? Choked you up a bit?
I'm something's coming out of my nose, at least.
Yeah, who's chopping onions in here?
I'm making a lasagna. All right, yeah, so tonight we continue our Eldritch Misadventures of Skids and Daisy, and we're taking it on to the Consternation on the Constellation, which, if you're unfamiliar, this is the custom scenario that we made for our Gen Con 2019 swag. We had Ian was kind of the front runner on this, but the whole podcast worked on it. We did a whole brainstorming episode prior to actually taking this on as a project, so go check that out. I think it was like episode 42. Called Cthulhu Catnip, if you want to check out the RSS. And we've not yet had this on our channel properly, because last time we tried to do this, we had such glaring technical failures that we just got so disheartened that we never tried it again. So I'm very glad that we're doing this tonight. I'm excited to show off our scenario on the stream. I think it came out pretty well. It's probably going to throttle us, but you know, that's part
we'll
of
see.
The course.
Yeah, I mean, it's not. I wouldn't put it as. It's not the hardest standalone, but
particularly with a campaign chaos bag.
Well, because our rules say you can't use the campaign chaos bag.
Oh, you're right, because it has a special.
Yeah. Bag. And Sean, actually, I was gonna miss here. Yeah, we have a live. We actually have an errata to announce. For this,
that's true. This is an official errata from the creators of this scenario.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if you can actually show and look up near the act and agenda deck, I have the card we're errating available.
Sure.
Okay. Right up here, this one here. You'll see it says playing the Consternation side story costs investigators 2 experience. During the pandemic, it is now 0 experience. So you all have no reason not to play this scenario. In your campaigns.
We did it!
Yay! Woo! Also, we're just tired of paying XP for side scenarios, and this is our scenario, so we're just doing it.
I'm so sick of not having anything to spend afterward. I like upgrading my deck because this is Arkham Horror the card game.
Yeah, this campaign has showed me, like, I used to think it was okay, because I used to throw in one side story into like an 8 thing campaign. Doing a lot of them just it hurts. So yeah, we're just changing that for everybody. There you go.
Excellent. So tonight, yeah, normally we don't bother to do a whole lot of to do with the narrative and the story text. I feel like since this is a side scenario and it's a little bit on the minimal side, and it's R1 and probably there's a lot of people who haven't had access to this, though it is available for free, print and play on our website, mythosbusters.com. We should probably bother to actually do the story text and whatnot tonight.
I think so. Yeah.
All right. So.
I did the intro, so you get to read all this stuff.
Welcome aboard. Join me on the other side of the sea. All your questions will find answers beyond the deep. You stare one more time at the cryptic note that sits on your table alongside a brand new set of first-class tickets offering passage aboard the SS Constellation, a luxury ocean liner sailing from Boston to London in a few days' time. Boy, that is a long sentence, Ian. The unmarked envelope had arrived just yesterday, promising a welcome solution to a vexing affair. In the past few weeks, several collections of esoteric artifacts in Arkham have been ransacked, culminating in the murder of an employee of the Miskatonic Historical Society. Your contacts have informed you that similar burglaries have taken place in Boston, Innsmouth, and New York. Strangely, nothing has been reported missing as yet, except for a few records and books. What could these people be looking for? You have a growing fear that it is something dastardly indeed. With leads running dry, hopping aboard an ocean liner in response to a note from an unknown sender seems only one step above a wild goose chase, but it's the best chance you may get. That in mind, you grab the tickets and head out the door. So, we've got Agenda 1A. Captured! You were awoken from your slumber by screams in the night, only to find that the ship had been taken by hooded figures. You find yourself trapped in a dank corner of a cargo room guarded by a member of the cult. This particular brute stands nearly 6.5 feet tall and watches you with wary eyes. So each copy of Order Enforcer gets +1 health per investigator and gains aloof and elite. Investigators cannot play or put into play item assets, including item weaknesses, or leave cargo room. Act 1A. Think fast. You need to find a way out of this predicament before the cultists decide upon a more permanent solution for you. So the Order Enforcer gains action parlay, test intellect 3 to trick the big lug. If you succeed, an investigator at your location may place one of his or her clues on him. There are 1 clues per investigator on the Order Enforcer. Discard him. Then objective. If there are no enemies in play, we advance.
Alright.
So, we're down here in Le Cargo Room.
The large room contains stacks of boxes, crates, and assorted luggage. There's also an access door that leads outside to the surging waters.
Trapped by the Order Enforcer. He's a 3-2-3. He's a 3-4-3.
3-4-3, yeah.
Yep. With aloof, Hunter retaliate. And reaction, when he attacks, you discard an item asset you control to reduce the damage by 1. Also, he's got some gnarly acne going on under that hood.
Yeah. Even cults need muscle. Oh, it doesn't make the clues. That's okay.
Well,
I will make them.
So, in the cargo room, you can test Intellect 0 to search the top X cards of your deck for an item asset and add it to your hand, where X is the amount you succeed by. Shuffle your deck, limit once per turn.
But we can't put items in play or into play.
Correct.
Yeah. While we're here.
Yep.
Because of the act.
Because of the act.
All right.
Okay, so as we closed last time, I went out by mental trauma, so here we are.
Oh, I also have a mental trauma. Just 1? I think? Mental trauma and a bunch of weaknesses in my deck?
Yeah, 1 mental trauma for taking Lita. For burning your house down.
Oh, and I also got knocked out in the hotel. I have 2 mental trauma.
Alright, well.
Or is it 1 and 1? I can't remember.
No, you got knocked out with damage, remember? So you're 1 and 1.
Oh, right. Okay.
Retaliate on the hotel security 3 times in a row.
Mm. Right, yes. And then he attacked me for a 4th time. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So only change to my deck from last time is I was able to upgrade 1 of my ancient stones into the thing that this deck is based around. So we'll see how we do.
I upgraded a beat cop. Yeah. That's it. And saved an XP, because I'll probably need it.
You have Studious, so let's draw 6.
My penguins are lulls. I never played this scenario. Are there any gimmicks or just normal? Oh, there's gimmicks.
There's gimmicks. There's a reason we can't use our campaign bag for this one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I should probably look at your stuff.
Probably want to keep stargazing.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to be around long enough, I think.
Probably want to... I definitely want to keep deduction for this opening part.
Yeah.
I think I can crack the case.
Okay.
You can get rid of Inquiring Mind.
I like that. I think.
Yeah. My lab assistant's going to draw me cards anyway, so.
Yeah.
Okay. Can't play them right away, but I'll be happy to play them shortly after.
Yes. I sadly only get 5 cards.
Plebe.
Oh, get away, you. Oh! Should probably mulligan that, right?
Of course. Why would you want that in your starting hand?
So I'll keep Lita.
Oh, yeah, you will.
Keep a weapon. I'll keep this because, you know, reasons.
Dude, I think you just keep that hand. No, Tarot's not an item.
Oh, yeah. Seat of the Crime.
Yeah, it's a really good card.
Okay, yeah, I'm not mulliganing a thing.
Very solid opening hand.
I've gotten Lita a lot.
She's been our constant companion this campaign.
Mm-hmm.
She's been our campaignion.
Thanks, Trench. It would say item if it was an item. Yeah, okay.
Oh, Casey.
So when the game begins, this thing pops out. Boop.
It is it your penis? Oh no, it's my, swords. Okay.
It's my sword. It's just my sword. Okay. Do you want me to go first?
I think...
And just scene?
Yeah, I think so, and then I'll work on the parlay.
Okay. Scene of the crime. I'll grab those two clues. Wow.
This almost feels like cheating.
I don't think Scene of the Crime was out when we designed this.
That's... probably, or it was very new.
Yeah.
But yeah.
So that's action one. Action two, I'll play Lita. Action three, I think I'll just draw a card.
Sure.
Actually, you know what? Before I play Lita, I'll draw a card.
Good call.
Yeah, okay. All right. I now have five combat. Oh, God.
All right. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. I wanted to select. Why you...
Skids is good, guys. You just got to get his combat up to five. Like Mark, and then you're good.
All right. Now my arm is complete again. Okay, so first action. Play down a lab assistant. Cool. Second action. I will parlay. Yep. So the parlay test is a three intellect. Yep.
Yep. Oh, you know what? You should probably show the bag before we start.
Yeah, it's probably
because it's a rough bag.
It's not great.
Yeah. You know, it's not terrible because I mean, look at that. There's seven tokens that are minus one or higher. Like just
there's
being
also two minus fours, a minus five, and a minus six.
Yes, but I'm saying at plus two. There's nine tokens. It's a 50-50 at plus two. And the skulls are minus twos right now. So even better.
Okay. So that said, I'm two up on this test.
Mm-hmm. Minus two.
All right, cool. So you move one of your clues to Enforcer. Eight. And I think last action I'll play a Stargazing.
Oops.
Get that in there. Did my deck load stars or right?
No, it didn't. It always comes over here. One sec. I'll do that for you. You can refresh and I will
Okay. So the Order Enforcer currently has Aloof, so he's not doing anything at the moment. So we will refresh. Nice.
Alright. See cut 10. There we go. Whoops.
Yeah, I have to imagine at a certain point here, Lita's going to start getting a little annoyed with us for how hardcore we've sidetracked her entire evening.
Yeah. It's funny to think of the story of Night of the Zealot. Here's your other one, by the way. It's funny to think of the story of it. Like, we burn down the house. You're like, quick, to town. I'm like, no, wait. Let's go to New Orleans. Let's head out to Venice.
Let me take a selfie.
And now we have to get back to North America on this ocean liner.
Are we going to do Midnight Mass next?
I mean, we'll see.
I suppose.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
You've kept up? Upkept?
I have. I drew a guard dog. I've doomed us. Doom one of two. And
Oh no, I'm sorry. Stargazing was in there. You already did that. I'm an asshole. All right, hang on. I got it.
Okay.
I'll correct it.
Oh god. See, listeners and viewers, this is what it's like to play with Sean.
It's true.
Just
guilty.
Now, if you just do this and go cut. There you go. There's 10.
Oh. Uh-huh. Oh.
There you go. Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Now pick up this.
Shuffle and then put it back down. Oh, look at there that. That is so fucking handy.
All right.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Am I lead? Are you lead?
Oh, I am, because you have wards.
Yep.
Oh!
Well, all right then.
I want to give it to you, I think.
I mean, I would probably just throw another stargazing into the deck.
Why not?
Sure.
Draws you a card, gains you a resource. Oh, wait, is that too many cards for you? Probably not.
Nope, I have max hand size of 10 at the moment.
Yeah, if you want a stargaze.
Yep, okay. So what's the order here? Draw a card, gain a resource, take an action. Draw a card.
Yep.
Gain a resource. Stargaze.
I'll just put that stargazing back in.
Thank you.
You can just get rid of your other one. That's funny.
Let me know when you're done.
Done.
Phew.
Come on, stargazing. Oh.
Cultist of the Deep spawns at the nearest location with an attached crate of goods. Any empty deck location instead if there are no crate of goods in play. Right now, I think he whiffs, yeah? There are no empty deck locations.
Correct. He whiffs.
Yeah. The little favorite mechanic of ours we had to bring back for our scenario.
Which, enemies whiffing?
Yeah, you don't see that very much anymore.
No, you really don't. Okay. Do you want to go first and, I don't know, do everything we need to do?
Might as well. So action one, I'll try that parlay again. Two up.
Oh my god.
Well, all right then.
Okay.
I'm gonna draw anything, but that's a success. So, your second clue hops up here. He is discarded.
He is.
And then, because there are no enemies in play, we advance. With the muscle taken care of, we've tricked the big lug, apparently. You now find your way. You now find the rest of the ship to be clear. Although you don't know exactly what the cultists who have taken control of the ship are up to, you're certain that they must be stopped. Very presumptuous of us, I feel.
Mm-hmm.
To put each set-aside location into play, except the lifeboat, and attach a random copy of the crate of goods to the deck lounge and theater, the passenger cabins, and the sun deck. And then we advance to Agenda 2A.
All right. And we need crates of goods. We got five of them. So we need to make sure that one of them is the tablet. That was in the setup instructions, by the way. We're supposed to grab three of these.
Yes.
I should probably shuffle these, actually. I hope we get the hand.
I hope so, too.
I think that's one of my favorite non-tablet ones. And which ones are they? It's Sun Deck.
It's the Deck Lounge and Theater, Sun Deck, and Passenger Cabins. Get a random crate.
And so Passenger Cabins?
Mm-hmm.
Deck Lounge and Theater?
Sun Deck.
Okay.
Holy shit, look at this map.
Yep. Oh yeah, I put all the other locations into play.
Got a big old map now. We'll get to these locations as we kind of move through them. But there's three mm-hmm. decks to the ship, and it's big.
Nick designed this map, so...
yep.
As you can
entirely
tell.
Entirely by himself with no oversight. We're sorry.
Yeah. We let him out without a leash, and this is what happened.
Okay, and then Agenda 2A, search the ship. The cultists rush through the ship in a frenzy, ransacking everything in sight. Clearly, they're searching for something, and whatever it is must be extremely valuable to them. Forced at the end of the enemy phase, place one doom on each crate of goods for each ready cultist enemy at its location. Remove all doom when we flip one, when we open one. Act 2A, find it first. From eavesdropping on the cultists, you hear one name repeated over and over. Lagrasse. The cultists seem to be searching for a certain item that a person named LaGrasse is transporting. He must search through the cargo marked with his name to find it first. If we find the Tablet of Dagon, we advance the act. We hit 12 doom. We advance the agenda.
Mm-hmm. All right. And the doom goes on the crates. So if we get a bunch of doom on the crate, we can then flip it to get rid of the doom.
Mm-hmm.
So our doom can go up and down. Rest of your turn, sir. You still have two actions.
Yes, I do. Okay, second action. I will pay 3 and put down a scroll of prophecies. Would you like a scroll secret?
I would not say no.
A secret?
Please.
It's yours. Draw 3.
I draw 3.
Discard 1.
Hmm. I think I lose my guard dog. No. Oh god, what do I lose, Sean? These are all good cards. This is what happens when you build a deck of just good cards.
I think guard dog is the right answer, because you already got Lita out. You're gonna play your beat cop.
Yeah. Bye, guard doggy. And I plan to have them out for a while. I'd like the cash to be able to pay for all the stuff in my hand.
Yep.
So, okay.
Okay.
All right.
Then last action, I'll move to the engine room. Engine room should normally be a noisy place, but it is eerily quiet. Cult is perhaps interested in keeping the ship precisely at this location.
Oh, whoops.
That was it fell out of your sleeve, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the engine room. While there's no clues on the revealed side of the boiler room, which is over here, the engine room gains action if there are no clues on the engine room. So you have to clear them both. Discard cards from your hand with a total of at least 1 intellect, 1 combat, and 1 agility icon. To seal the -6 token and add an Elder Thing token to the Chaos Bag for the remainder of the scenario. And remember that you have restarted the... Okay, that's my turn.
All right. I think I'm going to do kind of a half-y setup turn. I'm going to emergency cash, pull out a cop, so it's a total of -$1. And I'm going to move over to you.
Thank you, Blair Loss, for loving the scenario. Glad you enjoyed it. And My Penguins Are Lulls. This thing is published. It's out on our website, mythosbusters.com. Print and play.
Yeah, it's free. And like it's unless also... you want to pay. Yeah, you can pay to get it printed, but the files are free. You can just if you want to just proxy it in your home printer, you can do that.
It's available to everyone. Also, it's out on the TTS mod as you're seeing here. So
yeah, this is not us doing this. The TTS mod creator put it in. It's all like it's got most of the automation stuff. So, yeah.
Excellent.
All right, that was my turn. It was quick and dirty.
Okay.
I now have 7 combat.
Okay.
No, wait. Six. But, sorry.
Yeah. Who's counting?
Mm-hmm.
Mark.
I was trying to. Yeah.
All right. So no enemies. So upkeep.
All right.
Oh, damn it.
That. 1 doom of 12. That's a lot of doom we have. You know what really sucks? When you draw one of these guys while you're still in the cargo room?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
All
right.
I'm kind of sad that we didn't see the agenda. I mean, I'm not sad, but I'm also kind of sad we didn't see the agenda advancing as, you know, a partial designer, because getting hucked overboard is so fun.
Yeah.
Ocean's Maw. Revelation. Test willpower 3. If you fail, take a damage, then attach an ally asset you control to open water. And that ally gains action. Take control of this card if you're at open water. Any investigator may trigger this ability. So
I think
this is fine.
I think so too.
Like if I just lose my lab assistant right now, I'm not gonna be I'm not going to cry about it.
Yeah. Penguins are lulls. Yeah, that art is creepy. There's a creepier art. Vasilophobia.
Yeah.
Oh, that one gets me every time.
All of the art for the scenario was a joy to watch. When Ian did the majority of finding, I helped out a bit, but watching some of the things that he chose were...
Yeah.
Right, anyway, so I'm Ian.
All right. Toss her overboard. Minus two.
Yep. Yeah. So I'll actually just put the damage on the lab assistant. You can suck blood from a stone.
Oh, but then she doesn't go to open water.
Yeah, but then I don't take a damage.
Oh, right. Okay. Was that it? That was it.
That's it.
I have this guy in front of me.
I'll do something.
Okay. I am going to play my gun. But Scott, he'll attack you. No. I will narrowly escape it.
Nicely done. I love that card.
Yeah, you know, Nick sold it on me. Or sold it to me. This goes in a lot of decks for me now. All right, so that was my first action. Second action, I'm going to shoot him. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to 3. So 4 up. Oh, no, plus I'm a lot
six
up. 6 up. Okay, so he is, like, super dead. I kind of want to wait here just to help you.
It's probably a sound idea.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I do have some enemy management, but...
Yeah. Well, I figure you got to get these clues down her, so... Okay, I'll just gain a resource.
Cool. Alrighty then. I think for my first trick, I'll investigate. Actually, for my first trick, I'll give you another Scroll of Prophecies charge.
Ooh, okay. Find those weaknesses. Oh, boy.
Oh, shoot, I forgot to put my mask in my deck.
Oh.
Doodle. Oh, wait, did I? Let me check my deck list.
I think I lose... Watch this? I think I'm gonna... Wait, what are the icons we need for this thing? Fist, agility, and... Okay.
Yep, totally did. Alright.
Forgot.
No one minds a retcon. We'll just live in the universe where I put it in the deck, but I hadn't drawn it yet.
Yeah. I think I'm gonna check... Watch this. Because I am really not guaranteed to pass skills by a certain amount in this scenario.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Then for my first trick, I'll investigate. I'll commit a deduction. Only two up on this. Which is... There are a fair few tokens that fail me on two up.
No, Casey, I need an intellect to restart the engine, unfortunately.
You need a resourceful to restart the engine.
Yeah. Well, I have a take the initiative, too. Hmm. Yeah.
Oh. All
right, okay. So you're...
Yeah, sorry, my searching of the Carnival deck is finally coming around. Here we go. Sorry guys, my computer's showing its age just a little bit for you here.
While we're waiting, we'll just replay the intro. Every night in my dreams.
I can search the scenario when it's sitting here. Oh, right, I haven't finished searching.
Oh my god.
This, because reasons. Yep. On now.
Okay.
Oh boy. Boy, this is just thrilling entertainment.
Oh boy.
It's not worth it for the mask. Okay.
I'll give you a copy of my mask.
Here.
You can just...
Here we go. We got it. I got the set of sides right here. Oh, god damn. What are you? Search. Flippy. Pantalone. There we go. All right. Woo! We did it!
We got there.
Okay. So I'm two up. I could commit more, but there are things that I like.
What?
Did I commit?
I think
I've got a plan.
Okay, one sec. The bag, I think. That only gets you one token more, so no.
Okay. All right, that's fine. I'll sit at two up. Ooh. All right.
Okay, I'll grab the clues for you because they have the new counter thing.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So you just remove them.
And I'll move.
All right.
Do we tackle the boiler room?
Well, we want to. We probably want to restart the engine.
Okay.
I think we go for the boiler room.
All right, so. You can feel the heat wafting from this room. Your knowledge of ships tells you that this is where the steam needed to power the Constellation is generated. So after you end your turn of boiler room, put the top card of your deck face down in your threat area. Treat this as an exhaustion treachery with the following text. You get -1 combat, agility, and health. And then forced after you leave boiler room, discard this card. So, last action I'll investigate. At two up.
Here's your... Oh, yeah, end the turn, right?
Yep.
Whoops.
Cool, that's a clue. And then end of my turn. I'm -1 to those things good. Now.
Yeah, right, things well. That you really don't care about, actually.
Well, except for the health.
Yeah. But you'll get out of there.
Yeah.
I believe in you.
Here's the hope. Daisy's busy reading a book on how engines work.
My second vicious blow. All right. Good. I am set up to fight, my friend.
Very nice.
Oh, that was my turn.
Oh, that was it?
Because I killed... I'm refreshing because I killed the guy, remember? Sorry.
Sorry, the searching threw me off.
Yes.
Oop. It's happening! It's happening!
It's the upgraded ones! Okay. We are at 2 doom of 12. My encounter card is Sealed Doors. Right.
Revelation attached to your location. While it's attached to a location, you cannot enter or leave that location except by scenario card effects. Action, test, combat 4. If you succeed, discard sealed doors. You may take 2 damage to automatically succeed. And you can do this at a connecting location. It's a pretty brutal card sometimes. I think we'll be okay.
It is, but it's okay because I'm here. Now, Casey said something about, did we fix the doors? Casey, can you tell me what we need to live errata about this? It's probably some rules minutia, but I think. Anyways, you can play your, you can do your treachery and all.
Hey. I guess I'll just investigate, right?
Yeah.
How are you doing for things? You want the card and the resource?
I'm fine.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Draw a card. Get a resource. And investigate.
Casey says he thinks it was a timing thing, but it's fine. I think there might be something about the automatic succeed or something.
Oh, right. Yeah, that got clarified recently, right?
Yeah, so... But, I mean, I think spirit of the law.
Right.
They make sense, but I don't know if it's perfect.
All right, so I'll investigate at 2 up. Oof. There you are.
First
Hello,
one.
Friend. Yep, that's fine. You want to go first and get rid of that door?
Sorry, yeah. Yeah, I should go first. So I'm
God, I love stargazing.
6-4. You know, I'm going to do take the initiative to get it done, I think. Yeah. Okay. So I'm a 9-4. 5 up. Minus 2. Would have been fine, but that's okay. I assume you're going to get out of there this turn?
That's the hope.
Okay. Second action, I'll play down Bauta. Third action, I think I'm going to move up to...
And after it enters play, gain 2 resources.
Right, thank you. Third action, I'm going to move up to the galley, I think.
Basically superheroes on this ship right now. We don our masks, and now we're going to stop the cultists.
Yeah, pretty much.
Arkham Vigilantes.
I got a cop and a crazy lady behind me. He's not a real cop. He's like some guy who dressed up as a cop.
You know? He was in the play.
Yeah.
The Duck Lodge.
And I'll move up to the galley. The galley is the area where food is prepared for everyone on the Constellation. You can hear muffled screams and shouting coming from somewhere inside. Uh-oh. All right. It has... See, 2 clues, perfect, thank you. 3 shroud, and if there are no clues on galley, test 3 combat or 3 agility. If you succeed, you have freed the crew members from the refrigerators. Seal -4. Add a cultist token to the chaos bag for the remainder of the scenario. The sounds of distress are coming from a large refrigerated compartments. God, that'd be terrifying to be trapped in a refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
You ever worked in a kitchen? Like, yep. Those walk-in refrigerators?
Yeah, and that at lock? This point it would be like an ice box.
Yeah, and like no, probably no safety on the inside. Like they have the safety things on the inside now. You can push the button to. Anyways, that is my turn.
OSHA who?
Yeah.
All right. Let's have at this again. So, first action, I'll investigate. I think I'll be okay for this one at 2 up. And if I fail this, then we'll start getting serious about it.
Mm hmm.
Cool.
All right.
The clue. Second action, I'll move. Guards this. Oh, I was really hoping that would be my weakness.
No weakness. I'm not
gonna be that lucky. This isn't Dunwich. I'm gonna have to do something here. So.
Oh right, we had to restart the engine. I forgot about that.
Yep. So I'll play that guy. And then I had 6 secrets. Right, I did a 3 shroud location plus the 3 from the unupgraded version.
Yes, 6.
Yep. Then I don't think I'm gonna do that, but I will. Oh, we need to restart the engine. Okay, I'll stay here and do this next turn.
Takes an action, yeah.
Yep, that's fine.
I can cut. Yeah, okay.
I'm done.
All right, grab a resource, draw unch card. Steadfast.
Holy shit, this might be the game I actually play Daisy's Tope back. this might actually happen.
I mean, you can use it to restart the engine. No, you can't. No, you can't. Damn it, it has a willpower. She tosses her book bag into the swirling mechanisms. 3 doom of 12. Oh, here's the art. Here it is. That is the creepiest art.
So uneasy.
Oh.
Oh, look how deep that water is. You can't see anything under your feet. There could be anything in that water.
So test 2 willpower. Test gets +2 difficulty if your location is exhausted. For each point you fail by, take a horror. Subject shows intense and persistent fear of large bodies of water.
I'm right here, Scott. You don't need to talk about me like I'm not here.
I'm just going to take this even. I'm not worried about this right now. Skids passed the willpower test. You saw it here first.
I totally did.
All right. Oh.
Clicked. What happened? Okay. Rites of the Deep. I do really love this art.
Ooh, that art's nice.
Revelation, place a doom on the nearest cultist enemy. If there are no cultist enemies in place, search the encounter deck and discard pile for a cultist and draw it.
Okay. Here, I'll search because your computer is a potato, currently.
It's like a potato attached to a lemon at this point.
So, So we have two options. Well, we have three. The one we've seen before. I'll pull them both out here near the top so you can see them. We've got the Cultist of the Deep, who's the guy that whiffed earlier on in the game. Can you see these?
Where are you at?
Oh, here. I'll bring them down to you. All right. Here's our two options. So Cultist of the Deep will spawn away from you, which might actually be okay, because you're doing stuff, and I'd rather not backtrack.
Sure.
The Sea Singer.
Ooh, yeah. I don't want to deal with the Sea Singer. He's annoying.
Yeah. Annoying.
I don't know. It's a very feminine neck, but... Yeah.
I think it was supposed to be she. Yeah.
Yep. Give me... Let's do the Cultist of the Deep.
Okay.
So it spawns at the nearest location with an attached crate of goods. It's going to be here.
Mm-hmm.
So while it's at a location, that location is treated as exhausted for all encounter card effects, and because of the current agenda, it will now start to stack doom on that crate.
He will.
All right, cool. You want to go first? Let me go first, because I affect the chaos bag.
Sure.
So, I will use the ability on the engine room here. Let's see, what icons do I want to get rid of? I think we'll chuck so mind over matter and board? No, mind over matter and shortcut. Yeah.
Seems good.
Yeah. So shortcut, matter, and an action.
Mm-hmm.
And we...
Seal the
minus six. Pull that shit out of the bag and replace it with an elder thing. Mm-hmm. Instead of a minus six, we have a minus four. If you succeed, ready your location or exhaust a deep one enemy. And we have now started the end.
Yes. Now just to make sure that this actually works, and when it clicks back, okay, perfect. Sometimes when you seal something, it will sometimes jump back to the bag, but we're good. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right.
Second action, I will move.
Mm-hmm. You don't have another deduction, do you? Darn.
Don't at the moment. At this point, I'll just continue to investigate.
Yeah. I mean, that's what you do.
It is what I do. So, three shroud, right?
Yes.
Three, two up. Oop, that's a no. How are you doing on cards? New.
I'm fine.
Yeah, and I'll save my scroll for a time when I could do damage to an enemy.
Okay.
Which honestly, the Seasinger probably would have been the better call because I could have just pegged it with my scroll of secrets. Oh well. Lesson learned. Oh, well. This is the first time I've actually gotten this combo in this deck working. It's been theoretical up to this point, so I'm allowed.
Should I go handle this cultist?
I think you should.
Does he hunt? He doesn't hunt.
Nope, he sits and searches.
Yeah. Okay, so I'll move into the dining room. The dining room is a huge space devoted to luxurious consumption. Tables are covered in half-eaten meals of the sumptuous variety, while the gilded halls reflect the light from the hanging chandeliers. It'd be easy to lose someone in a room this big. Two clues. Shroud 2. Action. Spend a clue. Evade. Evade an enemy at this location or a connecting location. Group limit once per game. Oh, that's supposed to be automatically evade. That's supposed to be automatically evade.
Yep. Well,
yeah.
Lesson learned.
There we go. Errata. That just...
Live errata. You guys saw it.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm just thinking if I go there... So I'd be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, yeah. Second action, I'll move in. Ever so slowly. There we go. This guy joins me. In the passenger cabins. Uh-oh.
All right.
Yep. Forgot about that one. Okay, so this guy joins me.
It's been so long since we were in like heavy playtesting for this. This is honestly like playing it for the first time in a very long time.
So the passenger cabins, a long hallway stretches as far as your eyes can see, with the countless doors on each side leading to rooms for various passengers. Force, when passenger cam is revealed, search the encounter deck and discard pile for occultist enemies. Spawn it here. That enemy gains reaction. After this enemy is defeated, you have freed the passengers from their guards. Seal the -4 on the passenger cabins at occultist token. Yeah. Occultist stalks the hulls, keeping the passengers locked tight.
I think this time you grab the Sea Singer, so you don't have to deal with it right away.
Yeah. Casey's saying I should have evaded the guy. You have to spend a clue in the dining room to evade, and I has zero clues. So, let's see. Although,
Republic Life Human in good time. I need to put some energy into getting more clues at the moment. Although there's no.
I'm actually
going to location. Is
there? I'm going to take the Cultist of the Deep. Actually,
okay.
I have enough resources to pay for an extra action, and I just might be able to do this. So this one on the right is the cultist with the special text. The after he's defeated text.
Okay.
So I'll commit a vicious blow to this, popping off with my gun. So I'm a 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to 3.
I've upseen. All right.
Okay. So he's dead. And now this guy gets discarded and we seal.
Seal what was it? -4.
-4. There it is. The only -4 in the bag, I think.
There's two.
Oh, there's two. Yeah. And we put a cultist in?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Okay.
And now the cultist is a -2, so again, bag has improved. And if you succeed, you either deal damage to a cultist or remove a doom from a cultist. That's my favorite one. I always try to get the cultists.
Mm-hmm.
Because you freed people and now they're helping you. So like occasionally they'll come and bash a cultist for you.
And I will pay 2 resources to use a 4th action at Skids. Gun, vicious blow, same thing. Up by a lot. More than that. -1. And he dead.
Well, okay then.
All right. Hey, this deck is firing on all cylinders.
Rather efficient.
Yes.
Okay.
Anyways. Your turn was done too.
Yep. So no enemies left, so upkeep.
Mm-hmm. Through the gates.
Too bad.
No, that's okay, because it doesn't remove a card from my deck. This just
fire. Okay, it just pulls.
This just shows up. Yeah.
Okay. All right.
That's fine.
And that's fine.
Because you know what? A weakness, like part of the weakness, is you're just drawing. Well, no, you're losing a card draw.
Uh-huh.
So this just cut up the loss of the card draw.
Wow. So it did.
Yep.
Beauty.
And it's not one that hurts me immediately. So.
Hmm.
All right. That's me refreshed. Are you refreshed?
I am very fresh.
Quite refreshed. 4 of 12 doom. Clap of thunder.
Boy, this could hurt.
Let's see, fists. Is there anything I don't have? There isn't. Okay, well.
So revelation test, willpower 3. If you fail, you must choose willpower, combat, intellect, or agility. Those are out of order, by the way, Ian. Calling you out. Discard each card with at least one matching skill icon from your hand. No matter what you choose, you're losing something.
Yes.
But
I am.
At least you get to cherry pick what you lose.
So why don't I just commit steadfast to this?
Yes, because then you can pick willpower.
Yeah. Yeah. Which I didn't.
Nice.
Yeah. Well, I would have without steadfast, but. That's one of my favorite cards in this game. In this things.
Hey, Ocean's Ma.
Hey, Ma!
God, so... I think I'm just going to ward that, because now that I don't have an ally, I don't want to go. So.
Yes.
Ward.
Yes.
Okay.
You took your horror for the ward?
Yes.
Excellent. I just realized I'm not going to be able to get many clues.
Realized that I've got 4 clues and there's no victory points here, so I'm just wasting time. So,
first action. Well, there is the sealing thing.
Oh, that's
we
right.
could seal, which I could come back and do.
Okay. All right. So I'll work on this guy then.
Okay.
So first action, just because I have it and because this is like a decent midway point, I'm going to throw an open gate down here.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Here, I'll...
It's there. It's fine.
Yeah.
So first action, investigate. 2 up.
-2.
Cool, that's a clue.
Okay.
Second action, investigate. 2 up. That's a -4. Could have been a -6.
Could have been.
Either way, it's sad. Then, yeah, I suppose we'll just close it out here. Ugh.
Ugh. And I'll need some stat boosts.
Yeah, I'll take my I'll take my bonus tome action. Draw 3 and discard 1. I'm looking for my St. Hubert's Key, because getting to 6, I feel, would put me in very good range. Let's...
Is it tote bag? Because I think it's tote bag.
Is it tote bag?
Or is it lab assistant?
Might be lab assistant, but if I get caught by open water without an ally and without a ward, then that's going to be a world of hurt.
Yeah, tote
bag. I feel
bag.
Like I keep the lab assistant. I think it might be shortcut.
Yeah. No, I agree. Yeah, shortcut.
Much as I generally love shortcut.
Yeah.
All right, that's me. Glad I wasted 2 actions.
Yeah, God, I gotta figure out what to do that's productive. That's the well. You know what? I'm gonna come back here because once you get that open,
yeah.
Then I'll gain a resource and start paying off my debts. I think.
Sure.
So that's 2 resources on there.
Lovely.
All right.
There you are, you beautiful bastard.
Scene of the crime. I can do things now.
Ooh. I might let you finish this location off.
Oh, yeah, I could. Yeah, we'll see. All right. Seasickness. Revelation, put seasickness in your threat area.
This is my favorite treachery. It's so forced. Perfect.
Oh, yes. Forced. After you move... The next skill test you perform this round gets +1 difficulty. At the end of your turn, test 3 willpower. If you succeed, discard seasickness. That's going to be tough for Skids.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
That's, and I can't help you with that either.
Nope, you cannot.
Yeah.
All right. Your card, sir.
Shit. Sealed doors.
Okay. I can deal with that. That's...
Got an open gate and sealed doors, but the gate goes to nowhere, so it's not much help.
Do you want me to just grab that clue then?
Sure.
Okay. Let's do that. That costs 2. Grabs me the clue, which is good, because maybe I can help somewhat. Second action... I am going to attempt sealed doors, which triggers... Oh, after you move. Oh, okay, so it's all good. I think I might just take the damage to do it. Just to make sure it passes.
Okay. I mean, yeah, you're pretty more or less spotless at this point, right?
Yeah.
And you have a lot of allies.
I do. Put one on the beat cup, one on the Lita. This is my not upgraded beat cup. Right. Okay. So that automatically succeeds. Third action, I'm going to try this one. So I'll try combat because I'm a 6-3. My 6-3, yep. So 3 up. -2.
Nice.
Woo! And that is seal -4 at occultist.
Both minus fours out of there.
Yeah. You know what? I don't think we had a second minus four in there.
Whoopsie daisy. Asterisk.
Oh, God.
Republic Life Human, you pose a good question. And you might be right.
Yeah.
But my conditioning tells me never get rid of I've Got a Plan.
Yeah, I think it's also good just a one-time defense card where you're just going to go pow, like, mm-hmm. So I don't have to come and get you. Yeah.
And I've only got one charge left on my Scroll of Prophecies right now, so.
Okay, I will test for seasickness. Nope. Basically, I need a plus one or a...
other side.
Yeah. Yep.
Hit first action, 1, 2, 3, 4. Just suck it down. Then I'll move. Boop. Start working on that crate next turn.
Sounds good. That everyone? That's everyone. Oh, hey, before you move, can I have a scroll?
It's my only defense right now.
Okay, fair enough. That's fine.
Otherwise, yes, without question. When I get my next one down, I'll hit you up.
All right. 45 Thompson. Have I played the 45 Thompson this campaign yet?
The Thompson? I don't think so.
I'm not sure if I'm going to keep that in my deck.
I didn't think about the fact that Pantalone draws me cards, so that's actually a decent trigger on the Ancient Stone as well.
Yeah. All right, six Doom. We got a pitter-patter here.
Yeah. Get at her.
Lights out. Attach your location. Limit one per location. Attached location gets plus two shroud. You cannot play assets with a cost lower than the shroud of this location while at this location. After the location is successfully investigated, discard lights out. That is such a cool card. I love the design of it.
Mm-hmm.
Total whiff.
That's all Ian.
Yep. Like, yeah.
I mean, not necessarily total whiff. Like, while we're here, you can't play events, you can't play assets. Like, that pretty much locks you out from playing anything while
you can't
here.
Play assets. Assets. But it's only assets.
Does it specify assets?
Yeah, it's just assets. Because you're fumbling around in the dark, was the idea.
Oh, hey. That looks awfully familiar.
You can't play assets, but...
That's fine for now.
Why don't you go first, sir?
Yep. So, created goods. Action, test, intellect, or agility. 3 to sift through the contents. If you succeed, you may place a clue here, and when there is one clue per investigator, flip it over and draw it. So, I'll go ahead and do that. 3 up.
Minus 2.
Cool. So that's one clue. Do it again. 3 up. Clue. Let's see what we got. Oh, shit!
Oh!
All right, so.
Darn.
We got lucky. The tablet was the first one we saw. All right, so we're going to get an expedited play here. We might not even hit the top level of the ship.
Kind of unfortunate. I want to see some of the others.
Yeah, there are some really fun ones.
You know what we should do is, once we're done the game, anyone who wants to be... Anyone who wants to be spoiler-free can just stop, and we'll show them the other cards.
Yeah. I'm really proud of the other things you potentially find in those crates. They're pretty great.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so anyway, I take control of this bad boy.
Yeah. And we advance.
Also, we missed making this a tome. And I'll take my part of the responsibility for not catching
it. But it's not a tome, it's a tablet.
But, a tome is a book. This isn't a tome. This is a scroll, and it's just.
I guess.
I think
within
the context of this game, technically, this should be a tome. But it's fine. It's fine.
I feel like it's like the Ancient Stone. Like, look at the. It's an item and a relic.
Sure.
I think these match more than this. Okay. So move this over here so it matches.
That's fair. Move it over.
Okay,
so action, investigate. Your location gets plus one shroud for this test, and if you succeed, Move a deep one enemy to a connecting location. Smells oddly of sea and catnip. For some reason. Okay.
Because we named the episode that.
So, when you take control of the tablet of Dagon Advance, whoop! You found a strange tablet in one of the crates marked with Lagrasse's name. The writing on it is in some indecipherable and forgotten language. Although there's nothing to indicate it at first, the powerful aura that surrounds the object makes it clear to you that this is what the cult has been searching for. As you take possession of the artifact, the ship rocks to one side for a moment. At the same time, a ghastly noise reverberates through the ship, and you realize that it's the sound of metal being torn asunder. Terrifying creatures have begun to board the ship through these openings they have made. Shuffle the encounter discard pile and each encounter card from the Deep Ones and Sinking Ship encounter sets into the encounter deck. And exhaust each deck one location. Spawn the set-aside Colossal Servant enemy at open water. Alright, so I'll exhaust the locations because this is my favorite part.
Oh, and we're supposed to in setup we're supposed to remove a certain amount of sinking ships.
Yes, that's in setup as well.
I think it's one per
There we go. Remove one copy of Taking Waters from the set and then shuffle the rest in.
Really? For two player? Oh, right. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Because there's fewer per player.
Yes. Deep Ones and... That encounter deck just got thick.
Yep. Okay, spawn the set-aside Colossal Servant, Monster from the Depths enemy at open water. And then advance to punish the interlopers.
So Colossal Servant at open water.
Oh, never mind. Advance this to flee the ship, this to punish the interlopers.
Yep.
So punish the interlopers. They have it! Don't let them escape! The cultist knows what you have found and you're desperate, and they are desperate, rather, to get it back. Meanwhile, the creatures that have been unleashed are out of control, tearing apart anything that gets in their way. Exhausted locations do not ready during the upkeep phase, and if you haven't figured it out, they represent sunk or locations that
flooded.
Have filled with what? Flooded. Thank you. That's the actual word I was looking for. Forced, at the start of the enemy phase, discard each cultist enemy in the same location as a deep one enemy, then move each unengaged cultist enemy one location toward the investigator that controls the tablet of Dagon. They're coming for me.
Yeah.
Act 3A, flee the ship. Now that you have the tablet, you must take it out of reach, escaping the ship before the cultists find you and the ship is pulled into the depths. Sun deck gains. Double action, test combat 6. Hey, Skids. Or intellect 6.
Hi.
Hey, it's me. To use raw strength or intellect to lift the lifeboat into position. Any investigator may spend one clue to lower the difficulty of this test by 2. If successful, put the lifeboat location into play. Our current objective is to find and complete the objective on the lifeboat location.
Where's the sun deck? Oh, it's over here.
Yeah, it's way up. It's way up high.
Yeah. Well, why don't you start heading there and I will follow you.
Noted.
Because you're about to get into my favorite location of the game.
All right. So, last action. What, the library?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, right. Yes. Okay. We did something really dumb with this one.
We did something fantastic.
So I'll move into the library. The library is on the smaller side, but it is furnished with ornate sitting chairs, a heavy bookcase, and a surprising selection of tomes regarding the occult. A plaque reads... Special donations on loan from the Lagrasse collection. Oh, hey, that... Not enough.
Not enough. Wow, there's 6 clues here. Victory 5?
Actions, spend 1 per investigator clues and test Intellect 3 to learn more information about the cult. If you succeed, seal the -5 and add a tablet token to the chaos bag for the remainder of the scenario. Enforced at the end of the round, if there are fewer than one clues per investigator on the library, add it until there are one clues per investigator on the library. So scoring this location is particularly tough, and it's honestly probably one of the higher achievements you can hope to complete while you're playing Constellation.
Yeah, you pretty much have to have a deck built to do
I'm
this.
I'm out of here, or elusive, or...
Yeah, or in the know with deductions, and like it's possible. It's very difficult.
But good fucking luck.
Yeah.
Okay, that's my turn.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Ooh. I move to you.
Hi.
And I'm gonna pay off some more debt. Pay off 2.
Thing here fast. Oh, I didn't think to play something down. Oh well. I'll live. I couldn't have done it in the other chamber anyway.
Hmm.
All right, upkeep.
All right.
Yes. All right, so I think I'm going to get rid of the tote bag. We were so close.
We were so close. Yeah, get rid of the tote bag.
Because I think I'm going to play my Scroll of Prophecies before I see my Occult Lexicon.
Do you need your Occult Lexicon?
Probably not. But if I'm getting rid of my...
Oh, you know what?
But the thing is, if I'm getting rid of the lexicon, then I absolutely don't need the tote bag.
Right.
Except for when the Necronomicon hops out.
Okay, but also, we forgot to read Colossal Servant, so we should probably read him.
Absolutely.
He's in the water. Yes.
Yep, so forgot
so
about,
open water.
Forgot about this big boy.
Open water, I'll just read the flavor text. Trying to stay afloat in the cold ocean waters would be bad enough. Sharing those waters with hungry predators is even worse.
Foreshadowing. Right. The monsters from the depths, 5, 14, 4. Monster deep one and elite, massive and alert. Beginning of the investigator phase, reveal a random token from the bag. If one of the special symbols is not revealed, move Colossal Servant to the location of the most investigators. So the more special thing tokens you're pumping into the bag, the better chance you have of this not happening. And if there are no investigators at the same location, move it to open water.
Yeah, so he comes to attack you anywhere on the ship.
He'll just hop into play.
Mm-hmm.
And we, honestly, in playtesting and still now, even though I've made the mistake many a times, the easiest thing to forget is at the beginning of the investigation phase to test for him.
Mm-hmm.
To let us remember. And let me...
Discard a card?
I think at this point I do get rid of... I've got a plan.
Yeah, you don't need it. You got so much Tesla's damage here.
Yep.
So much. Okay. Oh yeah, doom 1 of 2. Draw a card. Slip away. Alright. Attach slip away to the current agenda. Limit 1 per agenda. As an additional cost to enter an exhaust location, test 3 agility. If you fail, you must either discard 3 resources or discard a non-story item asset you control. When the agenda would advance, discard, slip away. Oh, that's, we don't need that text.
Yeah.
But anyways, to the agenda.
Mike. Oh shit, destroyer from the depths. So when the enemy phase begins, discard the top 3 cards of the encounter deck and draw each copy of taking on one discarded by this effect.
Shall I help you with that?
I mean, I could just play Pantalone and kill him.
You take the attack of opportunity.
I would.
If
you've got nothing better to do, I won't say no. You could just punch him, because with the Lita damage, you don't even need to, like, need to shoot him.
Was he a monster? Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's super a monster. Look at him.
So, I'm 3 up? I think that's pretty good. I'll just punch him right there.
Fishy face.
Should I just punch him? Just pop him right in his mouth? Am I okay to punch you?
I mean, I could, you know, I'm hale and healthy, but I also...
It's only going to do 1 damage if I hit you. It's 2 if I hit him.
That's fair.
Like a half blackjack. Okay. Oh, I feel bad about that.
What?
I'll just take him. No, I'll take him. Yeah, I'll punch 3 up. All right. And then third action, I think I'll just move up to the location we're trying to get to, which is the sun deck.
Sure. We're not fucking with the library, right?
No, no, God, no. We can't. There's like...
Can
we
bother sealing the token while I'm here, though?
Unless...
Oh, wait, hang on. We just talked about it.
And then
immediately forgot about it.
Okay.
The investigation phase.
I'll draw the token.
Yeah, back the truck up. Oh, shit! Okay, so testing for the destroyer, or the,
This guy.
The Colossal Servant. We drew a special thing, so luckily we don't have to retcon anything, so he doesn't hop up. Oof.
Okay. Very good. Yeah, why don't we seal it? That's the last one we have to seal. Or last one we can seal.
I think I can spare the clues at this point.
Yeah. How many clues do you have? You had five?
I have three.
Oh.
I had to spend a couple to get the crate open.
Yeah, sure. Let's do it.
Because we'd take the -5 out and put in a -3.
Yeah, I like that.
And it's a good -3.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, it's like the gimmick of this scenario, so who would we... Like, it behooves
yeah,
us,
exactly.
I think, to show it off, right? All right, so action one, I'll spend two clues. What's the test? It's a 3?
3 intellect.
Okay, we'll go 4 up. No, we'll go... 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we're 6 up. Yep. Okay,
yeah.
So as good as we can get.
There. Oh. -2.
Cool.
I was waiting for a tentacle.
Seal the -5.
Yep.
Put in
we definitely
tablet.
Have that in there. -5. Oh, there's the -4. God. Okay. And put in the tablet.
Oh, really?
We
no
did
asterisk?
No asterisk.
Lovely.
We had.
Oh, yeah. Also, you didn't reveal this location yet.
Oh, whoops. Sundeck. This is the place where passengers would normally come to soak up some sunshine and enjoy the view. Unfortunately, the current view is of the unsettling kind.
Mm.
Two clues, no, or two shroud, no clues. Test fight. Test strength X. X is the fight value of the enemy at your location. If you succeed, shuffle that enemy into the encounter deck. If you fail, move to open water. That should be non-elite.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Live Arana!
All right. Okay. Oh, yeah, that was just your first action, right?
Yep. So I'll move up to you.
I'm spent. Yeah.
And the sun deck is where we move the lifeboat into position, right?
It is, yeah. It's currently a 6 test. You could spend clues.
Yep. So here's what I'm going to do. Last action. Let's spend a clue. Pull it down to a 4.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm going to commit my tote bag.
Uh-huh.
So I'm...
8 to 4?
I'm 5, 6, 7, 8, 4 up. Which I think is as good as we can get at this point, because we've pulled everything else out of the bag. That's worse than
yeah. That. Yeah, I think so.
4 up.
Yeah, yep.
Ooh, look at that! I'm so glad we did it! So it's a -3, and if you succeed, either draw 2 cards and gain 2 resources. I'll get the resources.
Okay.
And put the lifeboat into play. And guess what, Scott?
As we see in Venice, Daisy knows how to use her tote bag to maneuver a boat.
It's so true.
Thank you, Progress with Wolves. You are correct. Now we put the lifeboat in play.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, where is the lifeboat? Right here. And it falls way down here. It seems a little weird, but the way we kind of designed it is you're way up on the sun deck and you like unfurl the ropes or whatever, you let it go, and it falls all the way down to the water level. Mm-hmm. So,
and
lifeboat is like
to get in it while it was loading. So
no. Well, you might. I mean, this is a tall ship. You might assume it doesn't go down softly.
True story.
But lifeboat seems sturdy enough as long as you can keep it clear of creatures from the deep.
Then, pro play, fast action.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to throw down my open gate here.
Oh, yeah.
Save us a few move actions.
Oh, you know what? What if you put that on library and we tried to clear it out? And then, like, no, that wouldn't work. You'd have to put the other gate on, like, lifeboat
yeah.
or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't want to get greedy. This is actually going kind of well.
Yeah. I think we should go this way, though. Down. Oh, wait, but the gate. But there might be... I forget if there's victory points up here. Anyways.
I think there's one victory point between the two of these. I think it's on the bridge.
Yeah. Hey, do you have extra money?
Well...
Can you give me $1 to pay off my debt?
Did I take... Was I down to one when I took the resources? What did I play?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Oh, you played your Hubert's Key.
That was a while ago.
All right.
Hmm. I feel like I should have more, but it's fine. Yeah, you can have one.
One? Thank you. My debts. I paid them off.
Goddamn pinko commie socialist. Pay your own debts.
You paid 17% of it. Calm down. Okay.
No enemies?
No enemies?
No, none hunting anyway, so upkeep.
Correct. Oh, I should test for seasickness.
Oh, knew it! Knew it! As soon as I gave you money, I'd draw that asshole. You can kill him, right?
What? Yeah. Cool. That's what I'm here for.
Okay. Fine then.
Okay.
It's fine.
Good. All right, I'll refresh as well.
Actually, I can just pop my last charge on Scroll of Prophecies and fucking Knowledge of the Elders his face.
Yeah, that too. But you take an attack of opportunity. Oh, that's just one damage. Okay,
fine.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Okay. So, two Doom, we advance. Which, swept away, gets discarded. Sean, if you'd like to... Oh, wait, don't flip the whole thing. One sec. There's two there.
Oh.
So...
Yeah, get that out of there.
Here.
Below the waves, the ship tilts to one side for a moment, emitting a terrible groan as more water rushes into its wounds. Exhaust a ready location with the lowest possible deck number. So since all of the deck 1 locations are already exhausted, we have to exhaust a deck 2. So let's just do this guy.
This one? Yeah.
Taking on water. If all locations are exhausted, each investigator is defeated and suffers a physical trauma. Otherwise, flip this agenda back to 3A. Yep.
All right. Cultists of the Deep, nearest location with an attached crate of goods.
That's ours.
Oh, yeah, it is. I guess I'll put them on me.
Sure.
Okay. Your card.
Clap of thunder. Lightning and the thunder. I'm one up on this test. I think I'm okay sitting there.
You can just name agility or something.
Did we have a rule on how that works with wild? Like, do you have to just go wild
actually,
no matter what you name?
Wild only matches if you want it to.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Yeah, that's the actual rule, so this still works.
Cool.
So this is one of the easier ones. This can be amazingly easy or backbreaking.
Or it can wreck your hand, depending on what you
have.
Oh, hey, I succeed anyway.
All right.
All right, beginning of the investigation phase.
Yes. Ooh, this could go poorly.
Servant. Bullet. Okay.
All right. He's here. He's all that we feared. And I know. Okay.
So he big.
He is, which means your attack of opportunity is about to get.
Ooh, it just got real nasty. Okay, well that's not
so
great for my plans. How would you be to potentially evade him? Get on the lamb.
Well, yeah, but I have to engage him first.
No, you don't. He's
massive. Oh, you mean the big guy?
Big guy.
The big guy.
Yeah, I can handle my dude if you can evade the big guy.
See, I'm a 4, 5, 6, 7. What is he? Agility of 4? You have nothing to chuck to me, hey? My penguins are level 7. They have 14 health. He's a big boy.
I mean, I have a couple wild icons I could potentially throw you.
You know what? I might actually.
Not something that I'm crazy attached to.
I might actually be better off cracking Bauta.
Oh, okay.
And using.
Sure.
4, 5, 6. Okay, so I could get myself 6, 7, 8, 9 to 4. Oh, you only need to go to 8 to 4, right? 4 up is the highest. 7. 8. Okay, no, I'll just chuck on the lamb and my beat cop to go 4 up.
Yep.
On evading the big guy.
Nice.
All right. Is he a monster?
He is. You ever try to kill him? He's hard. We made him very, very hard to kill. He's like
Kingdom Aqua
levels of hard to kill.
Yeah, but like with my enchanted blade and stuff and Lita.
Yeah, you could potentially do a decent amount of damage. I could do, you know, 6-ish.
Oh, that is really tempting. Okay, let me kill this guy first.
Noted.
4 up using my gun on him. That's 2 damage. And then 3 up for my last punch. All right. And I'll test my seasickness. All right. Your turn, sir.
Okay. First action, I will scroll of prophecies. An attack of opportunity. Draw 3 cards. And when I draw 3 cards, I'll spend 3 secrets from Ancient Stone and kill my mob enforcer.
I mean, instead of wasting it all on that, you could have actually just gained a resource and done that and then used this on the big guy, and then we could kill him!
Do you want to do that?
No. Oh, God. I mean, I kind of really do. Because imagine taking this guy down.
Okay, well, let's have that discussion. He's got 14 okay. health.
Yeah, so you could do 6.
Uh-huh.
Right? So that brings him down to 8. Uh-huh. That is 3 successful strikes from my enchanted blade and he's dead. Which I can sleight of hand in.
Okay.
So I'd have to kill him next turn.
Okay. Alright. Alright, let's go for it. Sure.
Okay, let's do it.
You know, this could be the moment that we made the wrong decision that leads to our ultimate defeat, but, you know, fortune favors the bold, so.
So to retcon your turn, you still take the attack of opportunity.
Yep, so I got a resource instead for that action. Yep. Second action, be to parlay, use my 4 resources.
Yeah.
Get rid of him. And then last action, scroll of prophecies, draw my 3 cards, do 3 damage to the Colossal Servant. And then I will discard. Probably crack the case.
Yeah, I guess so.
There's no clues here, so.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Was that your whole thing? Is he parlayed? I think you still have an action left.
Action, parlay. Tome. Oh, yeah. Okay, and then I'll get a resource. Yeah. You know, eventually I need to be able to play more cards.
Yeah. All right. I gain 1. Draw a card. Intel report. Glad I got you now. Just kidding. 1 doom. Of 2. Is your ward upgraded yet? No. I'm going to crack Bauta on this one.
Yep.
So I'm a 6-3. I'm going to make that...
Yep.
7-3.
You definitely don't want to lose an ally right now. Oh, well. Fine. No cultists in play to trigger that, but it's
cool. Dang. Yep. Except for now.
Yep.
Fuck you, okay. Guys. Can you premonition?
I'd be happy to. I refuse to draw your token for you, though.
Okay.
I remember that time in Iron Man that I used premonition and then... Ooh, mm-hmm. Hey, that works. and then drew the autofail for Ian's big test, and it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't ever want to be responsible for that again.
So, do you have any wilds or agility icons? Because I'd like to evade the big guy.
Sure.
And then I'm pretty sure I can just pretty much get rid of him.
Can't be held responsible.
The only issue is I am down by 2.
I can give you 1.
Can you give me 2? Oh no, you can't.
I cannot.
Oh god.
I literally am incapable. Oh right, your only one is with Slight.
Yep. So here's the thing. I could commit the Slight and then no, I can't even play the Enchanted Blade then. I think I just gotta start attacking him.
Yep.
And then how are you for this went bad. We did a bad thing.
That was indeed the moment that our grasp overextended our reach.
Okay, let's
the
just...
the other way around. I can never remember which way that phrase goes.
Okay, are we killing this guy or no?
I
guess we had to...
Okay, at this point... We could nope out. We've got the open gate.
Yeah, we could.
What I need you to do is kill this Order Enforcer and then nope out if that's the way we're going.
Yeah. God damn it. We're so close to... That's 2 victory points. Huh. Okay, so how many victory are we currently getting? 2 is what we'll get from this. Yeah, let's nope out. Okay, I will commit this to evade him. I succeed. And by succeeding, I put a damage on that cultist next to you. So... That was my first action. Second action, I will punch him. 6-3. 6, yep.
Nice.
Okay. He's so I will dead. Put... He's LOL super dead. Third action... oh, this guy's exhausted. God... but maybe we could go back because we still have the open gate. I mean, he still may show up. That's the other thing. Right? Like,
true.
He goes back to open water when we leave, and then each turn he comes back. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now I'll test for seasickness. Nope. Okay, that's my turn.
Yep. I'll move. Do I just continue to move down?
I think so. Well, yeah, or like gain a resource, put out your Scroll of Prophecies.
That is what the other thing I was thinking is.
Yeah, I think you do that. I have still 2 weaknesses in my deck, so do not give me cards.
Well, I still have Necronomicon in my deck. So I'm not going to use this until I want to do damage.
Yeah. So
I'll just let it eat the scroll.
When we left, he went back down to the water.
Yep. Yep. So when there are no investigators at his location, he
moved over
off the side.
All right, refresh, and then we're gonna sync another location.
No, wasted.
No. If only you had the tote bag out.
Probably the scroll because I have other ways of drawing cards.
Yeah, unfortunately, like even Pantalonis here. God, That sucks.
It was gonna happen.
Yep. Had to have some bad luck in this.
Yeah, the weaknesses in this deck never fail to disappoint me.
Yeah. And I drew Narrow Escape. Perfect, actually.
It's amazing. Fucking seconds ago.
Yeah. We advance, so we just sink another. Sink another location. I'm thinking this one over here, library.
Yep.
My books. And we're at zero doom. Sealed doors. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. It's okay.
Sea Singer. Okay, well, there we go. There's the card draw.
Yeah.
So she Singer seals. Is the first time that's actually come out. So she seals the plus one or the Elder Sign. So I guess we'll have her seal the plus one.
Mm-hmm.
And that sealed token counts as doom.
And she does. Move. Yep. Oh, yeah. Note to people who... Yeah, somewhere. This is a busy location. note to other players. There's two of them in the deck, so you can get both the plus one and the Elder Sign sealed. Speaking of sealing and tokens and stuff, I will draw a token for the big boy. So he can possibly...
No whammies.
He's on us. Okay, now do we kill him?
I think we can still afford to nope out, right? Get to the lifeboat? Or, okay, so here's my other option.
Yep.
I can throw down my pantalone.
Yeah.
My existence part of that attack of opportunity.
Uh-huh.
Use pantalone's damage to kill the Sea Singer. And then use Pantalone to evade the dude.
Sure.
Right?
So I'm just thinking, I can do another 6 damage to him this turn.
Casey, that saying that has never, ever come to bite me in the ass, ever. Don't ask Nick.
That's a big ask from you. That's probably, yeah. It's probably the best way to go about it. Because we need to get to the boat. But that's going to take up most of your turn, right?
I mean, okay, so what's... Did you have a counter offer?
No, I don't. Like, I'm just saying it's going to take up most...
Oh, well, the other thing you could do is potentially play down your Enchanted Blade, Narrow
with
Escape.
With Narrow Escape. Yeah, that's what I plan to do.
Okay, yeah, all right. Oh. I'm fine with that.
Oh, evade him, hey? Okay, yeah. Yeah, no, that makes sense.
For an open out?
Well, I'll be 6 to... I'll only be 2 up for evading. That's probably what you'll be, though.
Sure. Well, I mean...
You have the Pantalone?
Yeah, and I've got Pantalone if this fails, so...
Okay. So I'll play down my Enchanted Blade. With my Narrow Escape. 2 up on evasion. Here we go. Whew! He has evaded. And I will move out. And you're going to be able to take care of the Sea Singer?
Yep.
2 health? Okay. Oh, and I'll test for seasickness. Nope.
Okay. Yeah, so first action, 1 resource.
My penguins are lost. What are the rules for sunken locations? They don't inherently have anything, but the skulls get harder. Skulls are -4, and there's also a few, what is it? There's like treacheries and stuff that deal with them as well. So inherently they don't have anything bad, but they're just not good to be around.
That's dead. No.
Just put it like right here, the blood spot, and then... Right there. There you go. Here, one sec. Okay, send that back.
send that back.
Okay, stop.
Uh-huh.
There. Ah! Here, I will just move them
just go
to the bag.
The bag.
Yeah, trying to be fancy.
Trying to shortcut with our shortcuts, and it's not shortcut.
Yeah.
Okay. So, action two, action three. And I guess, God, is it even worth it to work away at the Necronomicon at this point?
No.
I mean, I've got a free action, and I don't have...
Okay.
I don't have any... Yeah, I mean, might as well.
Sure.
Again, might regret it, but we'll see.
Yeah.
There we go. Right. Okay, refresh.
This guy goes away, over to open water. Oh, shoot, sealed doors.
Fuck us.
Okay.
You paid two resources and did two damage, right? Or took two damage? Oh, wow.
No, I don't have resources to do that. You know what? I stay there with him.
Sure?
And I bust down the doors for you. I'm not sure, but what else can I do?
Hero.
I know. So I have to do it, so I'll take the damage. Alright, I'll put one on Lita, just in case she gets pulled under. No, actually, because there's that, I'll take it on me. Alright. That's it. Alright, so, enemies ready, big boy. Oh, I just drew my sleight of hand.
You got rid of this, though, right?
I did, yeah. Oh, Sean, we fucked up real good. Lights out, dude. We have to redo that whole turn.
You didn't...
I played my blade.
Yep, okay, yep.
No, you know what? I didn't. Okay, here it is. Because what I would have done... Okay, pop that back in my hand. I would have still had my narrow escape. So my first action was to bust down the door, which I took two damage. Then I evaded him.
In an attack of opportunity, though.
Right, with the which I narrow escaped.
Oh, right.
Yep. Yeah, so instead of playing my blade, I broke down the door.
Yep.
It doesn't change the...
And then that gives you an extra action to move out, though. Because you could spend two resources now, since you didn't play your blade.
I can still move out, because I just didn't play my blade.
Oh, right, that's
so, true. So now I'm here, so I can just be like this.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So okay. All I did was exchange, instead of playing the blade to get the narrow escape, I broke down the door. That's, yeah. So no hidden information changed.
Yeah.
We just read the fucking cards.
Right, we just played like we were actually playing instead of streaming.
Yes, RTFC. All right, so one doom of two. Call of Relief. When you would move while there is a deep one enemy in play, you must move toward the nearest deep one enemy or take one horror. After you engage a deep one enemy, discard Call of Relia. Relia.
Oh, Relia. Up here.
Yep. One of those two.
That's neat, technically.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll draw the token for Big Boy. He does not show up.
Literally the only time in the game I'm glad to see that fucking tentacle.
Mm-hmm. All right, you want to go first?
Sure.
All right.
First action, I'll move to the lifeboat. The lifeboat seems sturdy enough as long as you can keep it clear of creatures from the deep. Seems a thing. So after it's revealed, discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until a deep one enemy is discarded. Spawn it here. Forgot about that.
Oh, we need a deep one, hey?
Whatever one gives...
I can kill?
Like, does the least damage in horror.
Okay. So the Wake Titan?
Oh, God.
Just kidding. No, it's gonna be the little fishy dude. The destroyer.
Yeah.
Okay.
Objective, if there are no ready enemies at this location and each undefeated investigator is at this location, we may spend 4 clues as a group to get to R1.
But there's 6 clues, but there's victory 2.
Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is premonition.
You've already used 2 actions, right?
Nope, just 1.
Oh, right. Okay.
1 to move. So premonition. I will evade. I'll evade and I'll use
pantalones. Oh, Bauta? Oh, yeah. Pantalones.
I'll replace this with an intellect test, so he is evaded. Buys me a turn. And last action, I'll investigate. Commit deduction. That's a 7. What's the shroud here? 4.
4. And the highest thing in the bag is a -4, which is the elder thing.
7, 8, 9.
No, you only need to go to 8. There you go. Yep.
4 up.
-2.
Oh, 2 clues.
The lifeboat is not a deck. So, okay, I got rid of those 2 clues for you.
Yep.
I will move, and you don't. I'll, okay, so I have to move towards a deep one, right? Okay.
Which you did. And now Which you're I about did. To engage one, so that Call of Relia should resolve itself.
Yeah, but my seasickness, so. So it's a +1 difficulty.
I didn't draw you.
Stop it. I could just punch him. I'm 2 up. I'm just going to punch him 2 up.
Yeah. It's a +2 difficulty.
Plus.
Because of seasickness.
1.
Didn't you move twice?
Oh, yes. Okay, I missed him. Yep. Whoops.
But now you're 1 down on this, so you might actually succeed it.
I'm 1 down on what? Oh, yeah.
Seasickness.
Well, no, I'm... Yeah, 1 down. Yeah. I failed.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, no moving enemies. This guy puts a doom on a crate, which makes it... we're going to advance. But...
He doesn't put a doom on a crate. That was the agenda. Did that.
Oh, right. So okay. Happen. Well, we're still in the witching hour anyway, so. Yeah. Let's see. Refresh. He engages me. The fishy dude. Which discards Relia.
Lovely.
And that's it. So we advance because we hit 2 doom. And now I have to sink another part of the ship. Dining room?
Yep.
Any objections? Cool.
Yep.
Oof. Taking on water.
Go.
This is the only one I can choose.
Apparel, exhauster ready location with the lowest possible deck number. So.
Which
all of deck 2 is flooded.
Yes, we have 3 left.
Blastophobia. Luckily, my lifeboat is not yet flooded, so this is fine. It's 2 up. I think I'm okay here.
My penguins are lulls. Here isn't exactly a flooded location thing. +2 difficulty if your location is exhausted. So you could take up to 4 horror from that, which is brutal.
-3. Damn it. All right. Well, I fail. By 1. So take a horror.
A horror. Okay. Okay, let's draw a token for Big Boy. Here we go.
Woo!
Woo! Okay. We're good. He sticks around.
Okay, I'll clear the Necronomicon for what it matters.
Okay.
Action one, investigate. Two up. Three up.
Okay. Sure you don't want to save her for soak? I guess you're never going to play her. All right. Okay, got a clue?
What I'm finding in this deck is it's mostly resources. Like, I totally would have played the tote bag if I wasn't so choked for me.
Yeah.
And then my life would have been easier. Oh, well.
All right, you so got a clue? Yep, I took it off.
Second action, investigate. Yeah, I'm probably not going to play the Alexicon at this point.
Yeah.
Three up.
Okay, last action, do Inquiring Mind.
Yep. Five up.
Yeah. All right, so there's two clues left.
So we can advance. We can potentially get this victory points. The victory points mm-hmm. if we're lucky and or daring.
We don't need to be lucky. I have intel report.
Oh, yeah, you do.
I'm going to flash that out to my magic card speaking.
Pocket blade. Cha-cha-cha.
Just to make sure I can nail this guy. Hopefully. So I will spend a charge on 4, 5, 6, or 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to 3. He's dead.
Nice.
4 resources to grab 2 clues for my location.
Nice.
And we can R1.
Spend 4, R1. Woo!
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, I'm spending 3 clues just to feel like I did something, okay?
Noted.
All right.
Resolution 1. You work the oars of the lifeboat furiously, pushing yourself beyond endurance in the vain hope that you might escape the clutches of the horrific creatures that have overtaken the Constellation. Whether by fortune, providence, or some mysterious power, no foul monster finds its way aboard to end your flight. The tablet in your possession glows with mysterious colors, reflecting the lights of the northern sky overhead. Astonishingly, you watch as the deep ones crawl back into the ocean as the Constellation recedes behind you, the ritual seemingly aborted. A horn sounds through the fog, breaking your reverie. Rescue has come. In your campaign log, record that the ritual at sea was halted. In your campaign log, record that the Constellation was saved. Mostly sunk, but somehow still saved.
Saved-ish.
We earn victory X.
Alright, let's see. It's 2, 3, 4. Let's just count the library. Okay. that's 4.
4, okay. We missed the bridge. And I don't think the deck lounge has it. We missed the bridge and we missed one enemy.
Yeah.
I think the Wake Titan has victory.
Yeah, there's a victory in there.
And of course, Biggins.
Yeah, he's 2, yeah.
Okay. So then move to additional rewards under page 7, or page 11. Additional rewards. Add a +1 token to your campaign chaos bag for the remainder of the campaign. And you know what? It's fucking broken, but I don't care. For how the beginning part of this campaign has gone, I don't give a shit. I want to see that +1.
That is the best campaign. I think that's one of the best rewards in the game. Yeah, I love it.
And if the Constellation was saved, proceed to trust earned. When you make it back to shore, you're greeted by an older gentleman with a familiar name. The Grass, he says, offering his hand. You did well to save the ship. Since I've learned of the existence of such things, I've dedicated my retirement to trying to keep dangerous relics out of the hands of cultists, of people like these cultists. But they will go to seemingly any lengths to grasp at horrible power. I thought I could safely transport these relics in secret across the sea, but I was terribly wrong. Thank you for your help. I'll be in touch. Any investigator may choose to add Inspector LaGrasse to his or her deck. This card does not count against that investigator's deck size. So LaGrasse! You get an additional accessory, an additional hand slot, which can be used to hold relic assets. And after a cultist enemy or location is defeated, exhaust him to discover one clue or gain two resources. I'd like him, if that's okay. This is amazing.
Yeah, you know, initially I was thinking, oh yeah, for sure. But then I realized he can also hold my blade.
Yeah, but he can hold my stones.
Yeah, it's true. But are you going to defeat cultists?
No, but yeah, no, we're often cool. I'm often at your location.
Yeah, you take it.
We're going to have to remember to add this manually to my deck every game, because yes. This is not an Arkham DB.
Okay, one sec. Give him to me. I'm going to save him as an object.
In here, let me give you a fucking Antelone as well, because I know I'm going to forget that.
Oh,
shit.
Yeah.
There you go.
Well, you can add that in Arkham DB.
But I probably won't, though.
But I'm going to make sure you do.
Okay.
All right. Inspector LaGrasse. There we go. Saved. Awesome.
Woo!
He can hold... my penguins are all as I heard that, too. He can hold my stones.
I stand by that statement.
So I guess we're just going to do a sign-off, but if people want to stick around, we can look at a couple cards that were not revealed.
Mm-hmm.
So anyone who wants to be spoiler-free, you can end now. All we're going to do is like show and talk about cards. You can come back whenever you played this scenario. But
and as a reminder, this is available on Tabletop Simulator, and it is available for print and play. All you need is printer and paper and sleeves and proxies at mythosbusters.com.
Yep.
Get up. Free to everyone. And I'm pretty
proud
of
you. Thanks for joining us. If you're going to pause now. But if you're not, okay, spoiler zone entering. Should we look at open water?
Yeah.
Because that has been there since the beginning.
Yeah, no, nothing hit it.
Nothing. Well, we actually have to go in there, because even an ally goes in there.
Mm-hmm.
Goes in there, but... it's terrible.
Not great.
No. So, 6 shroud, 0 clues. Forced, when you move to a connecting location... test 2 agility or 2 combat. You may spend any number of additional actions. Reduce the difficulty of this test by 1 for each additional action spent. If you fail, cancel the move. So you can... The reason we actually designed it this way was because of Daisy.
That's true.
Like, we're like, what about Daisy?
Investigators like her.
Yeah, exactly. Minty fan, you know? Same thing.
Norman.
You can spend... You can pretty much guarantee it. Except for 1 token. By just spending the extra actions. Forced, at the end of your turn, if you're in open water, you must either take 2 damage or discard a non-story item asset you control. So you're flopping about and either take damage or you start dropping stuff.
As you do.
Let's see what crates we would have had here.
Oh god, that's like, okay, I'm like, for our campaign as a player, really yeah. Glad we found the tablet right away.
Yes.
As a part designer of this scenario, I'm really sad we didn't see anything from the other crates.
Yes,
let's see.
I agree.
What was up here?
Okay.
Yes, this is my favorite one.
Oh,
Hand of the Strangler. So you open the crate and out pops this motherfucker.
Yeah.
Cannot be defeated, cannot be evaded. Action, fight it. You can fight it with either combat or agility, and if you succeed, you either move it to a connecting location, which is kind of an evade, or you attach it to a non-elite enemy at your location, and at the end of the enemy phase, you deal a damage to an attached enemy, or obviously it's an enemy, so it would deal damage to you. So you just throw the strangling hand on an enemy, and it goes to work, regardless of where it's at.
Mm-hmm.
It's so fun. Like, when this pops out, like, it's super annoying, but goddammit, I love this so much.
Yeah. I like how it's relic traded.
Yep.
And elite, yep. Okay, the other crate... was Ring of the Deep. Item, relic, and cursed. Revelation, the investigator with the lowest willpower at your location takes control of Ring of the Deep. You get -1 willpower, -1 sanity. Double action, discard cards from your hand with a total of at least 3 will icons among them to remove Ring of the Deep from the game. Takes up your accessory slot, so you can bump something out.
Obviously heavily inspired by the Dagon relics from Shadow of Runesmith.
That was just word salad to me. I don't know the story. All right. Other crate. Oh, this is a good one. Abyssal Sword. Item, relic, weapon, and melee. Revelation. Choose an investigator at your location to take control of Abyssal Sword. You get +1 willpower. Action, fight. You get +1 attack, +1 combat, and +1 damage for this attack. If a cultist, tablet, or elder thing symbol is revealed during this attack deals 2 additional damage, takes up a hand slot.
I really wanted this to be a scenario reward, but we decided that it was way too powerful, but awesome. And it was part of Ross's collection, so he wouldn't like.
Yeah, it was a bit too powerful.
But fun when you find it.
Yes, and you have a 1 in 5 chance of getting it. So, you want to read the last one?
Sure thing. The Crimson Ledger is item, relic, and cursed. Revelation, take control of it. Free action, remove the Crimson Ledger from the game and take X horror, where X is the remaining health of a non-elite enemy in play, to discard that enemy. List calls for you.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's fun.
Two good ones, two bad ones, and the goal one was how we designed them. Like, these two are beneficial. Two are not. And then you have the tablet.
And if we need to sell you even further on playing this scenario, there is a whole alternate path that this scenario can take if you don't manage to find the tablet before the that agenda runs out. And there's a different boss and a different end objective. So I'd say that if you know what you're doing, or are lucky, I can't tell you which we were tonight.
We got lucky. Getting
60 to 75% of the time you'll see the ending we saw. But if the cultists get an upper hand on you or you get unlucky, you can see some other cool shit.
Yeah, the big enemy. So if you get the tablet, the Colossal Servant comes out. If you don't, Luther Marsh comes out. Empowered and Enthralled. He's 4/5/4, but it's 5 per enemy. Yeah, the Witch King, hey? Massive and Retaliate, which is gross. Does he retaliate? He doesn't. He's alert.
Oh, yeah, alert, not retaliate.
Luther March cannot be defeated by damage. Forced, after Luther March attacks you, test 3 combat. If you fail, move to a connecting location.
He'll just knock you through walls.
Yeah. And you'll be like, well, how can you beat him? I'm just going to leave that a secret. So.
There is a way.
Yeah. He's, it's tougher though. I think it's, well, I don't know. It's, yeah. I think they're pretty well balanced for difficulty once you either get the tablet or don't get it. But yeah. I played this at Arkham Knights this year. And with a group of, it was 4 of us, I think. And we got the tablet on the first crate as well. Mm-hmm. And we finished with 1 location still up. That's, like, it was the...
It's by the hair of your teeth, huh?
Yeah, it was the last round before, and we were going to advance. Like, we had to finish that round, or we were going to die. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm very glad that we finally got to play Consternation in the Constellation, and it didn't go horribly wrong, and we actually got to finish it one way or the other. And it actually went pretty well. Like, I get to upgrade my other stone, which is cool.
So we get 4 XP?
Yeah.
Oh, nice, yeah. Oh, here. Here's an encounter card I want to show.
Yeah, there's a couple we didn't actually see.
Yeah, I'll look for other ones, but you can read that one. I'll see what else to...
Sure. The Out of Air Revelation, if you're not at an exhausted location, a gain surge. So obviously this only happens in the second part. But if you are at an exhausted location, test Agility 3. If you fail, take a direct damage and put it into play in your threat area. And at the end of your turn, take another 2 damage if you're at an exhausted location. And then once you move out of an exhausted location, you discard Out of Air. So it's really rough if you can't get rid of it or if you can't get up to air. So once you pull this and you're down in the sunken depths of the ship, it can be real rough. And Biggins. Or Biggins Jr.
Wake Titan, he's a 5/5/2. Monster, Deep One, and Elite. Massive and a Hunter. Forced, exhaust the location when Wake Titan spawns. If able, forced, after Wake Titan is defeated, ready its location, if able. Victory 1, and he's a colossal creature, smashes through the bulkhead and bellows in bloodthirsty excitement. 2 damage, 1 horror. So it's kind of weird. I absolutely love the way he works, where he exhausts the location when he comes in.
He comes in just like the fucking fish Kool-Aid man.
Yeah, he just smashes through the bulkhead. Ooh, the weird thing is, though, let's say you're half the ship is sank, like ours is, and you're down in the boiler room or something. And then you defeat him, and the boiler room suddenly unfloods. But then it floods again, like, next time you advance. It's the one part I'm like, oh, that's kind of weird, but I don't care.
He smashed a big hole. It was the next thing to flood. Makes sense.
Yeah. Yep.
All right.
That's I think that's pretty much it for it.
I think that's about it. So if you haven't played this yet, for fuck's sake, go play it.
It's really fun.
It's really fun.
Bring all your tokens, all your chaos tokens yes, to the table.
You will need them.
It says that in the instructions too, like, keep them handy.
Alright. Well, Scott, thus continues the Eldritch Misadventures of Skids and Daisy.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're headed to the Bayou next time, right?
Did we already do the Bayou? No, we didn't.
Oh, we have not.
We haven't. Yeah, I guess we have to.
Boy, yeah, because we want to.
Well, we want to do all the ones where you can possibly die last.
Right.
Yeah. So yeah, Bayou next, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess we got to pay the 1 XP for that, but I'm okay.
It's fine.
Yeah.
This is the only one we had any say in the cost. So yeah. We've done our piece.
Bullerana. Yeah.
All right. Excellent. Well. Thank you, as always, to everyone for joining us here and for watching on YouTube. If you haven't already, join our Discord, because that's where we announce when we're going to be going live next. It'll probably be at or around the same day and or time next week, unless Scott gets crazy busy, which, of course, is a definite possibility.
It may happen. Yeah. It may happen.
So, yeah, everyone, we'll see. Stay safe during quarantine, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.